Hi guys, back here with the All About Beauty series in skincare. I'm actually going to go through each type of skin type and just things that you can do or what you should or should not do. So I'm going to start with dry skin. I know because it kind of applies to most people with winter. Now it's important that washing your face too much is just as bad as not enough. Especially in the winter when you're washing your face too often, you're getting rid of the natural oils that we have on our skin, which dries your skin out. So you might want to apply a moisturizer often during the day, maybe more so than you do in the warmer months, or use like a cleansing cloth that has some sort of vitamins or moisturize in it, like an aloe in it. At nighttime, just use a mild cleanser. Do not use anything alcohol-based. Because it will just dry your skin out more, like astringents and such like that. When your face is damp, apply any lotion or moisture because it will lock in that moisture on your face when you do so. And also, if you're going out like in a wind, carry like some sort of lip balm. You could also use it when your skin is very dry. You can use it on your cheeks. There's no color to it. It will moisturize your skin and it will help you from getting even more dry. So I'm gonna go to oily skin. If you have oily skin, it's important that you use alcohol-free 2% salicyl. I don't know how to say it. It's S-A-L-I-C-Y-L-I-C, salicylic acid. You always contain this ingredient if you have oily skin, and it will just help the oil. It will help absorb all the oil off your face. It's important that you don't forget to moisturize. I know since you already think you have the oils on your face, you don't want to moisturize, but you need more oil-free lotion. It's still important that you moisturize in essence because most moisturizers include some sort of SPF and that will help prevent sun damage on your face. For oily skin, exfoliation or any mask is really not recommended often as someone like me with normal skin. Those things tend to have a lot of different ingredients and different moisturizing effects that may cause more oil on your skin in conjunction with the 2% salicylic, I can't say it, acid toners and other products that you're supposed to use to get rid of that oil. Sensitive skin is next. Sensitive skin, you need to use fragrance-free products. A lot of the time, the breakouts that people get is because of the ingredients that are added so the products smell nice, end up contradicting the whole point of buying the product and make people break out. If you do have sensitive skin, test the product out on your neck before applying it to your whole face. This should be common sense. You want to cleanse and moisturize in the morning. You want to use products that are especially made for sensitive skin. And for people with acne, I'm going to include that right with sensitive skin. You want to wash your face both in the morning and the night with the acne formula cleanser. You also want to moisturize with SPF 30. The reason why you're going to moisturize with something a little bit more than most people do is because most acne products contain ingredients that actually increase sensitivity to the sun, so you want to prevent any sun damage to your face. You want to avoid any abrasive products or any scrubs, anything that's going to pop pimples or cause any sort of scarring on your face. A lot of people say, like I said in my past videos, that you should switch to a mineral foundation. A lot of times the oil-based foundations tend to clog pores. If you have a certain sort of skin type that is acne-prone, it may actually add to that chance of getting acne. And I'm going to just finish it off with body care since it is skin. If you notice on your shower door or your curtains that you have like a chalky kind of thing, it means that you have hard water. And hard water leads to dry skin. So it's important that you not only install a shower filter or tell your parents or whatever it is to do so. It will remove some of the harsh chemicals. It will also help your hair, which is the next video I'm going to do. And it's important that you lotion and moisturize your skin when you get out of the shower if you do have hard water. That was odd to say. It's important to shower in warm, not hot water, okay? And do not do this for a long period of time. You will break out. You will dry your skin out, okay? Another thing is use moisturizing shaving gels and use razors that have three or more blades. Stuff like that so you don't get the razor burn or you get anything, any sort of rash or dry skin as a result of not moisturizing enough before you shave. And lastly, put body lotion on your skin while it's still damp. It will soak in just much like moisturizer and it will seal in moisture, which is important, especially if you have the hard water. So I hope that these facial and skincare tips helped you out. Please stay tuned for a hair care, make a hair care tips video. I'm not even gonna edit that out. Bye.